गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द डिसीज. एक्चुअली बिफोर दिस अप टू दिस वी आर स्टडीड अबाउट द हेल्थ एंड द सिस्टम इन बॉडी, द वर्किंग सिस्टम विच इज हेल्पफुल फॉर कीपिंग द हेल्थ, दैट इज द इम्यूनिटी सिस्टम. एंड नाउ स्टडी अबाउट द डिसीज. सो you know what is disease? Disease means it is the condition of when a organ or organ, any organ system does not work properly, then this is called as the disease. Means disease is the condition in which a organ, any organ or complete organ system does not work properly, or their function is deranged or altered. The altering functions of organ or organ system, this condition is called as the disease. Now disease are normally categorized or divided into two types. There are two diseases are of two types. Before starting, you know the names of diseases, like cancer is the disease, AIDS, diabetes, then malaria, typhoid, corona. So these are the different diseases. And now these diseases, for example, cancer, diabetes, typhoid, corona, malaria. So these are the different types of diseases. Now these diseases are divided into two categories. So these are called as communicable diseases, communicable disease, or it is also called as infectious disease. This is the first type, and second type is non-communicable disease, or it is also called as non-infectious disease. So the diseases are divided into two categories or two types. First is the communicable disease, it is also called as infectious disease, and second type is called as non-communicable or non-infectious disease. Now see here, what is communicable or infectious? Means these diseases are transferred from the infected person to the healthy person, means they are transferred from one another, that is called as the infectious disease. The infectious means first type of cancer, it is not spread from one person to another person. Diabetes, it is not spread. If in our family one person has the diabetes, then it is not transferred to the other family members. Means it is non-infectious, it is not transferred, non-communicable. Typhoid, it is transferred from one person to another person. Malaria, it is transferred from one person to another person. Corona, now it is highly infectious or highly communicable disease. So communicable diseases means which are transferred from one another. For example, malaria or corona. And non-communicable disease, its examples are cancer or diabetes or any some non-communicable disease. So commonly diseases are divided into two types: communicable infectious disease or non-infectious disease. For example, cancer. Now see here about the communicable disease. Means they are transferred from one person to another person, and the diseases are caused. For example, these communicable diseases are caused, the positive agent, they are caused by the virus, they are caused by virus or bacteria or they are also caused by some fungus. For example, infectious diseases also include some skin diseases which are caused by fungus. Then some insect or worm, for example Ascaris, these are caused by some living agent. All these agents now called as pathogens. So this is causing organism is called as pathogens. Pathogen means it may be bacteria or virus or any worm or fungus. So they are responsible for causing the disease, and these diseases are spread from one person to another person. So they are called as infectious diseases. And this pathogens sometimes need some another living agent for reaching up to their host. For example, this virus. This virus cause, suppose this is the polio virus, or it is the virus which cause the malaria, or protozoa which cause the malaria. This pathogen, this protozoa, is also the pathogen. And this particular protozoa does not directly reach to the person. They need another organisms. These are called as vector. It may be mosquito, or it, the vector is like mosquito or house fly, or some another small organism which transfer the disease from one person to another person. So they are called as the vector. Pathogens means these all are called as the pathogens. So now we are going to study about some different types of diseases in this chapter. Some diseases are non-communicable, means like cancer, then AIDS we are going to study, and some communicable diseases like malaria and typhoid are studied in this chapter. So the first communicable disease is the malaria. So malaria is the infectious or communicable disease transferred from person to person, and the pathogen, the disease causing organism, the positive agent, that is called as the positive agent of this malaria is the protozoa. One type of protozoa is responsible for causing the malaria. And the name of this, protozoa, means microscopic microorganism, single cell microorganism. That is called as the protozoa. Proto means small, initial. Zoa means animal. These are the very small microscopic animals. And the name of this particularly protozoa is Plasmodium. So this Plasmodium is responsible for causing the malaria. Now this Plasmodium are of different types. There are four main species of Plasmodium. So the first species is Plasmodium. Genus is Plasmodium. Species is Plasmodium vivax. Second is Plasmodium ovale. Third species is Plasmodium falciparum. And the fourth species of Plasmodium is Plasmodium malariae. So these are the four species of Plasmodium: Plasmodium vivax, Plasmodium ovale, Plasmodium falciparum, and Plasmodium malariae. Of these four species, only this Plasmodium falciparum causes a severe infection or symptoms of the malaria, Plasmodium falciparum. And the symptoms of these three species are mild. They are also responsible for causing the malaria, but their symptoms are mild. Falciparum causes the severe illness. Now see here about the Plasmodium. This Plasmodium does not reach from person to person directly. So he need a one vector, and its vector is living organism which transport the plasmodium from person to person. This vector is mosquito, and particularly the species of this mosquito is Anopheles, and particularly from Anopheles also it is only the female. So the female Anopheles mosquito acts as a vector, means it transport the plasmodium from one healthy infected person to the healthy person. And this male Anopheles mosquito actually feeds upon the plant sap, and only the female Anopheles mosquito sucks the blood, and so it can responsible for transferring the plasmodium from one person to the another person. Now see here the mode of transmission of malaria. Before this, see the symptoms of malaria. First, the symptoms of malaria. Actually, after the entry of pathogen, the symptoms occurs within 7 to 14 days. Means after the entry of pathogen, symptoms observed in the person, after the 7 to 14 days are observed, then the symptoms of malaria is very common. The first symptom is fever, then sweat, then shivering. So these are very common symptoms. Actually, they are not, these symptoms are not useful for differentiating or for the diagnosis of malaria. Some another symptoms are like the vomiting, then arthralgia, means the joint pain, headache, then convulsion, then hemoglobinuria, means less of hemoglobin, anemia, then infection to brain, then retinal damage. These are some symptoms of the malaria. The first symptom is fever, of course, the fever, and temperature rises up to near about above 100, means it reaches up to 104 degree Fahrenheit. So very increased body temperature or fever is the first symptom of malaria. Then sweating, means after the fever, the sweating and sudden rigoring, means shivering, takes place, and these symptoms are disappear after 4 to 6 hours. So generally they are disappear, and again these symptoms observed in the person after 2 or 3 days, means the cyclic occurrence of the symptoms observed in the malaria. Cyclically fever, after the two to three days again there is a fever, then sweating and shivering, then person becomes normal in 4 to 6 hours, and then again after 2 days or 3 days the symptoms occurs. Then the next symptom is first stage symptoms are fever, sweat and shivering. If the malaria reach up to the second phase, then there is vomiting, abdominal pain, joint pain, that is called as the arthralgia, a severe headache. These are the symptoms of malaria. Then in the third phase, if this malaria virus infect to the brain, then some symptoms related to brain is like the convulsion. When in severe case, in third stage, the infection or there is anemia is also observed because there is a damage to the hemoglobin or RBCs get damaged. So number of RBCs get damaged and the condition is called as the hemoglobinuria, less hemoglobin. Then due to the less hemoglobin, anemia is there. Then retinal damage is also observed because the less RBCs are there. And so it may be responsible for the damage of eye retina. These are the symptoms of malaria. Now for these are the symptoms. Lakshana ethe malaria che. Then prevention and treatment from malaria. One very common medicine is useful for curing from malaria. That is called as the hydroxychloroquine, you know. And prevention from the malaria is use of mosquito net, use of mosquito repellent means to avoid the mosquito bite. These are some measures, that is the use of mosquito net, then use of mosquito repellent, then to control the mosquito, use of insecticides are useful for killing the mosquito. Then avoid the stagnant water or drain the stagnant water. Water je aithe raudesani. Then gambusia fish is also useful for controlling the mosquito because this gambusia fish feeds upon the mosquito larvae. The larvae which are the mosquito gives the eggs in water, and from the eggs the offspring comes out, that is called as the larvae. And this gambusia fish feeds upon the larvae, and so it helps to minimize the mosquito. So these are the prevention from the malaria, particularly to avoid the mosquito bite. And now the mode of transmission of the disease, how it transmit from one person to the another person. Suppose in blood of infected person, this protozoa is present, and the stage of this protozoa, Plasmodium, is present in the blood of infected person. And this stage protozoa is called as sporozoite. Actually, this Plasmodium completes its life cycle into two hosts. It requires two hosts, that is the man and mosquito. Man and mosquito. So see the mode of infection. This sporozoite present in the salivary gland of mosquito. Now this mosquito bites to the healthy person. When this mosquito bites to the healthy person for taking the blood meal, at that time from the salivary gland of mosquito it inject the sporozoite into the healthy person. Sporozoite enters into the blood of healthy person. Now this sporozoite from the blood, it circulate or reach up to the liver. In liver it enters into hepatocyte cells of liver. It enters. Here the mode of infection. Actually this Plasmodium this protozoa is present in the salivary gland of mosquito. Now this mosquito when bite to the healthy person for taking the blood meal, at that time this sporozoite enters into the bloodstream of the healthy person, and from this it reach up to the liver, and in liver it enters into the hepatic cell. Now this sporozoite in liver cell, this is the liver cell, hepatic cell, and this sporozoite now called as merozoites. This sporozoite divide rapidly and gives many small cells, that is called as the merozoite. Now this merozoite ruptures the liver cell and enters into the bloodstream, and again they enter into the RBCs. These merozoites enter into RBC. Now they reach, and firstly they enters into the bloodstream. From the blood they enter into the liver cell, and then where they get divide or differentiate to form the merozoite. Now this merozoite rupture the liver cell and enters into the blood, and from blood they again enters into the RBCs, and now in RBC they are called as trophozoite. Now this trophozoite rupture the RBC. They rupture the RBC and comes into the bloodstream, and now they are called as gametocyte. So the next stage is, first is the sporozoite, first stage sporozoite. Second I have merozoite, which takes place in liver. Third I have trophozoite, which takes place in RBC. Many trophozoites, many merozoites enters into many RBCs, and so there is a rupturing of many RBCs, and so at this stage the first symptom of the malaria is observed, that is the fever. Due to the destruction of many RBCs, the body gives response or signals in the form of fever. So body temperature is increased, and so it need near about 7 days for the occurrence of the symptoms. Means many merozoite enters into the RBC, and RBC, many RBCs get ruptured, and it releases the gametocyte. Now these gametocytes are of two types. These are also the cells of the plasmodium, but gametocytes are of two types: female gametocyte and male gametocytes are present now in the blood of this person. Now this person is called as the infected person or the malaria person, and in this person blood, female gametocyte and male gametocytes are present. But the next development or stage of development does not take place in the human body. Now the many female and male gametocytes present are in the blood of the infected person. Now when this another mosquito bites to this infected person, it sucks the blood from this infected person. So along with the blood, this male and female gametocytes takes enters into the body of mosquito. Now in mosquito, it enters into the mouth, and from the mouth they reach up to the gut. Means it's digestive tube. This female and male gametocyte enters or reach up to the gut, and in gut there is a fusion, fertilization of male and female gametocyte. Fertilization takes place, and there is a formation of oocyst. Now this oocyst get developed into to form the sporozoite, and now this sporozoite, or the sporozoite which are developed into the gut, migrate up to the salivary gland of mosquito, and then when this mosquito again bites to the another person, suppose this is the healthy person, then during the bite this mosquito inject the sporozoite into the skin of this another healthy person, and then it become the infected person. So this malaria transfer from person to person, so it is called as the infectious or communicable disease, and it is caused by the protozoa, that is called as the plasmodium. And this plasmodium reach from one person to another person through the mosquito. So mosquito acts as a vector, and the development life cycle of this plasmodium completed into the two host. The first host is the man and the second host is the mosquito. So the first infective stage, remember this, the sporozoite is the infective stage of plasmodium. It is the infective stage. Means only sporozoite can infect the person. Sporozoite enters into the liver cell, where they get developed and differentiate into very small cells, that is called as the merozoite. Now this merozoite rupture the liver cell and enters into the blood, and in blood they enters into the RBC only. In RBC they get developed, that is called as the trophozoite. Now this trophozoite ruptures the RBC and enters into the bloodstream, and now these are called as different types of trophozoites are there. Some trophozoites are called as the female gametocyte and some are called as the male gametocyte. But these two gametocytes does not fuse in the human body, in human blood. Only up to this the development takes place in human being. Now this blood of the infected person has many male and female gametocyte. Now this along with blood, when this mosquito sucks the blood from infected person, along with blood the female and male gametocyte enters into the mosquito. And in mosquito, from the mouth they enters, goes up to the gut, means elementary canal. And in elementary canal there is a fusion of male and female gametocyte and formation of oocysts. Oocysts develop into sporozoite. Sporozoite reach up to the salivary gland, and from salivary gland during the bite they enters into the another person. So this is the first type of infectious disease, that is the malaria.